Empty Planet, The Shock of Global Population Decline, written by Darrell Bricker and John Ibbitson. Darrell Bricker is an author, public speaker, political commentator, and CEO of Ipsos Public Affairs. John Ibbitson is a columnist for the Globe and Mail, having served as bureau chief in both Ottawa and Washington, D.C., author of several books. His 2005 book, The Polite Revolution, was shortlisted for the Donner Prize.
Empty Planet seeks to demonstrate that the predictions of the United Nations that our population is exploding, it will go to 11 billion by the end of the century, all those assumptions are wrong.
The world's population isn't going to continue to expand forever.
In fact, because of steadily decreasing fertility in the developing world as well as the developed, it's going to top out somewhere around 9 billion in the middle of the century and then start to go down.
This is very contrary to what a lot of demographers have been arguing, particularly the United Nations. So we were really intrigued by the idea of dealing with a topic that a lot of people out there just assume is correct, the answer to the question is correct, but actually the answer is incorrect.
We had both read the relevant academic literature, but what we both agreed was we needed to get the argument out because there were too many people who didn't understand that argument.
This is going to be the most important development we're probably going to see this century, and it was a story that was really worth telling. And it combined both of our expertise, John's expertise as a reporter and my expertise as a statistician and an understanding of population trends.
The takeaways economically are not encouraging because you have fewer people every year being born, which means you have a smaller society every year, which means you have a smaller economy every year. So more old people depending on fewer young people every year. That's not going to be healthy.
But the other impact that it's going to have, and you're having very little conversation about this today, is on fertility. And again, a counterintuitive thing is that when people say, for example, through a snowstorm or a power outage or some other reason for a shutdown, are forced to stay home, the expectation is that what we're going to have is a lot of kids produced. Actually, that doesn't happen. In fact, the exact opposite happens.
All the evidence suggests that an economic downturn produces a long-term suppression of fertility rates. We saw that happen in the economic recession of 2008-09, and I expect we're going to see it happen in this recession big time.
Well, John and I wrote this book for a popular audience, and we wrote it for a global audience. Basically, we looked at anybody as being a potential reader.
Well, of course, we would like politicians and planners and academics and demographers and statisticians to read our book because we think that there are decisions that we have to make about how many schools we build versus how many long-term care facilities we build.
What we really want people to get out of the book is that this is the single biggest thing that's going to be happening this century. And anything else that happens around it is really going to be affected by the population change that we're talking about here. It's going to change just about everything that has to do with anything related to the society and the economy. So these are the building blocks for understanding what our future is going to be.
Darrell and I are very grateful to the Donner Foundation and the jury for shortlisting Empty Planet this year. We are both very grateful to our agent, John Pierce, who has worked with us now on two different books, to Douglas Pepper and to everyone at McClelland and Stewart, who were the lead publishers on the book, and to publishers from China, the United States, Britain, around the world, who have translated the book and produced it in their own markets.
This project wouldn't have come to fruition without the real persistence of our agent, John Pierce, at Westwood. He really brought this together and brought the project home. Also, we had three major publishers who really worked on this, plus some international publishers. And it was Doug Pepper from Random House here in Canada. It was Tom Asker from Little Brown in the UK. And Emma Berry from Crown in the United States really drove this project. All of my colleagues at Ipsos, who I visited as I traveled around the world and interviewed. But most importantly, it took time on my weekends and my evenings away from my wife Nina and my daughter Emily, and they more than anybody are responsible for my ability to be able to create this book. So I want to thank them, and I certainly dedicated my contribution to the book to both of them.
Empty Planet, The Shock of Global Population Decline, published by Signal, McClelland and Stewart.